Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I am going to teach you how to learn words based on the particular parallelism that exists between Farsi words and English words, or words from other languages. Okay, let's start with a very easy example. In English, we have these three words referring to time: yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Now, let's look at the equivalent of these words in Farsi. In Farsi, for yesterday, we have diruz. For today, we have emruz. And for tomorrow, we have farda. Okay, now, if you look at these words, you will notice that there is a parallel between English and Farsi in this case. For example, with yesterday, we have two elements, yesterday. Exactly the same scenario happens in the Farsi word, which is the equivalent of this word, diruz. Now let's look at the word for today. In today, again, we have two elements. So we have today would be emruz. Another parallel there. Now, when we get to tomorrow, there is no trace of the word day in the English word tomorrow. Same applies in Farsi. We have farda. No trace of the word ruz. This is a good way to learn words in Farsi because you will see how these words are parallel to their English equivalents. Of course, this is just one example. We have many examples like this, but I know that you get the idea. Let's now focus on the words which are completely different from English. This is another way to learn, to remember that some concept is fundamentally different in Farsi compared to any other language. So, for example, in English, we have two words, man and woman. The word woman in English is a combination of wo, man. So you see an element of man, a trace of man in this word. However, in Farsi, the words that we have for man and woman are fundamentally different. Each of those words is completely independent from the other. So this is a way to remember that when it comes to Farsi, these two words are not formed like the way that they are formed in English. Let's look at that more closely. So the word man in Farsi would be mard, and the word woman in Farsi would be zan. As you can see, there is no linguistic connection between the word mard and the word zan. So despite the fact that we do see a linguistic connection in English between these two words, in Farsi, there is no linguistic connection between these two words. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. I want you to understand that learning any language is not a one-dimensional task. When you're involved in the process of learning a language, you have to summon up all the knowledge you have from all the languages you know, in order to learn this one language the best way you can. So if you really focus on certain elements in a language, you will find these connections between the things you don't know and the things you already know. Until the next class, khudafiz!